Yes.
I'm still on Brian's page. Do I stay there?
Yeah. That was me. Yep.
I sure do. I actually got two because I was looking at it, and then I found an article that kind of relates to it. So it's kind of relative, so I'll jump. So it says, if we make mistakes in our first compositions and do not know them, we may not amend them. By Leonardo da Vinci. So I thought that was real cool. And then I found this little article. It says, creatives fail, and the really good ones fail often. So it shows to me that if you can at least learn from your mistakes, you get better that way. Where most people, you know, they go downhill from the mistakes.
Sure. Okay. Well, for me, the Academy is more than just a coincidence. It's a safe haven. It's a place where I can help and be helped, give and receive, teach and be taught. More importantly, it is a place where I can develop personally through the technology of composition. My vision of the Academy is a family of composers who raise the human consciousness. Thank you. It's typed. I put it on the Skype. Okay. And let me see. Okay, let me get there. I put it under my name. In the comment section. But it's under my name, that's what I'm saying. Okay. Wait to see, I just forgot the whole thing. Yeah, it's there. Then, in closing, the quality of your work depends upon the clarity of your intention. And your intention stems from the strength of your composition. Yes, right. Well, let me start off by saying that my last one, the three-quarter view, can that be seen? Or do we have to see that? Because talking in the air doesn't seem to make sense. Yes. Yeah, I think we should do that. Just show the last one. The first one. I see your face.
I see it.
Yeah.
No, I just see a picture of you. I'm on Brian's call. I mean, his name is says current calls, Brian. Maybe I wait. Let me try to get you. Maybe I don't. Maybe that's what it is. I don't know. See, the only box I have now is current calls. It says Brian. Oh, there's the picture now. I got it. It was there. Go back. But that's not the one from last week. Yeah, that's the last one I did, yes. Okay, well, this is the, can you all see that now? I don't see anything now.
Yes.
Hello?
You can see it.
Okay. So, in this particular, this is the last one I did, which was done about maybe 4 or 5 hours ago, and Victor asked me to make some corrections, but the first one, the ear was not in the correct position, and Victor mentioned that I should change my dominant vertical, which I did. This one, and then as a result of that, I did a series of them, one with a beard and one without a beard. This is one without the beard. It's on a root 5. And so I did one with the beard. I did also with a cheek structure on the right side. So there are two different looks, and this one was without the beard, and yeah, it keeps going in and out. I can't see what I'm, you know. But the thing about this whole process is trying to get an understanding of how can I make things happen the way I envision it in my head, to do it according to with the composition. And by using the different grids, it gave me an insight into different ways of seeing what I thought I want to accomplish. And working with the grids, it's another level of development in terms of learning how to work with them. So like some of the ones I have, you'll see there'll be lines that really don't look that nice, but in my mind, what I was doing was trying to follow the grids. And then from there, I made shifts and alterations. It was a challenging experience from the standpoint that I had so many different looks to consider. I didn't know which ones I wanted. It kept changing in my head. That was driving me kind of crazy. Yeah. Well, it wasn't until I they did this last one that I really sort of figured it out. It says, oh, okay, just put the stuff where the lines are. In other words, where the vertical lines are or the horizontal lines. I was trying to, like, fit the lines to the piece that was underneath the tracing, you know, the tracing paper. And so that's not going to work. So by doing it, just following the grid, it may not look like what I thought I originally wanted to look like, but that's the way that grid comes across. So just follow the grid, not to have a preconceived notion about, and don't force it, just let the grid guide me. That's what I get out of it. No, it's not. Right. Yeah. It's a mess. Well, see, that's where part of my confusion was. I was trying to keep the line from the original, image. But like you say, it doesn't really fit. Right. Right. Yes, I can. Yes. A change in what? Yes, it did. Right. Okay. Yes, that's the beard set. Yes. Uh-huh. Okay, right. Right. Okay. Right. Yeah. Right. Right. So I need more diagonal on that on the nose there. Okay. All right. Yeah. Okay. What about there's one thing, and what about that the goat, the beard? Yeah, right. Yes, she does. Right. Okay. Right. Now, so I should get rid of that the right side cheekbone thing structure? No, the other side, the right, yeah, right that. Yeah. Right. Right. Right, I got you. Okay, don't want to hold up. Going to somebody else. Thank you.
Sorry, I have a question. How many images were there? You showed on the different sketches how many. Yes.
Yeah, 7 or 8. Yeah, right. Mm-hmm.
Okay. Should we focus on all of them, like as a whole, or do we focus on a specific one?
Yeah, I was just exploring, based upon the grids, how it would look.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So I had okay. None of them were like absolute. None of it's absolute. It's just like, how would it look like this, or what could I do using that particular tool?
Okay, I understand. Okay. The last one you were working on. Yes. That one and the first one, please. The first one at the top. The first one at the top. That one, yes. Okay, yeah, thank you. Sorry, I have another question. Where do we put in the notes in the website? The feedback, where can we type that in? Oh, okay. Cool. Thank you. Okay. All right. Thank you.
Ain't talking about a shaft.
Just 1 minute.
Yes. Whoosh. Right. Well, it's a blockage. I see that. Okay, I got you. Okay, so now where can I go for my comments for reviews? Yeah. Yes.
Yes, just did. It's wrong.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm still right, man.
Where? I shrunk, yeah.
Yeah, I don't need any images.
Okay. Yes, my name is Michelle. Yeah, and my last name as well. Yes. No, that's okay. It doesn't have to be right now.
No bacon for you.
Correct. Yeah, I just wanted to get a sense of, I wanted to understand the concept, and I'm not sure I do yet, but I prefer to work on something that I already had instead of trying to figure it out with something new. Thank you.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
Nice.
Thank you. Yes. Yes. Because I'm not sure if it's only one dominant horizontal or if there can be more than one. Is the attention of the viewer supposed to be fixed on one horizontal line, or can it go between? That's the part I wasn't sure, and I wasn't sure which of the two was more important. So I just, Yeah. Aha, okay. Okay. Oh. Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah. Yes. Yes. Oh, okay. Interesting. Yes. Okay, that makes sense. Okay. Well, the arc, I thought that the shape, because of the shape of her face, like the way she's looking downwards and how it's like, in a way, it is is the opposite of the back of her head because of the afro, and it's like two arches, but they seem to be mirroring each other, but in opposite directions. But with all the elements kind of focusing in the area of her face, I feel that the dominant arch would be her features, her face, right? And that I would focus, like looking at her now, I would focus I would say the diagonal, the dominant diagonal would be the one going from the top of her head, going through her eyes and her nose and her lips down to her chest. And the arch could be that same one that I already have. And the dominant horizontal would be the one, the second one, the one at the bottom that goes across her collarbone. Because all the lines are. Yeah, that's very good. Intentionally, it would be exactly where it is, because I think it draws in the viewer, like by seeing the like when you look at the image, and you see the way her face is tilted down, like she's looking at something or someone, and the shadow in her neck, and it kind of brings attention to her neck and her collarbone, and that area. That's where I would make it intentional.
Hello, Victor?
Hello?
Hello?
Okay, Bill, can you hear me? Oh.
I was just going to ask him, like, if she's look, if the focus is looking down, then wouldn't there be a diagonal from the eye to the back of the head? Wouldn't that be where it would be?
I would thought about that too. That's a good question. I feel like she's more pensive than listening or looking at something specific. It's more of a, there's something, she has something on her mind more than, Yeah, it's a line. Yeah. You connect the dots. Yes. Okay.
Don't mess up that afro.
Yes. Yes and no. Okay, yes, I understand what you're saying, but no, because what happens when you're working, like in this case, I use a photograph as a reference. It's not the exact copy of the photograph, but the positioning of the face and the shadows of her skin and whatnot to get the skin tone, I got it from the photograph. So, No. I want it to look realistic. So, realistic in the sense that if, for example, somebody was standing next to her or next to her, behind her, there's obviously going to be a shadow cast on her neck or her skin or whatnot. So in this case, with her afro, the hairline, there's going to be a little bit of shadow. So how do I play with the shadow that's naturally there to get all that movement in the face without it looking like it's not real? I know that, as a composer, you're supposed to have this, you make up the rules and you have control, but I don't know, I guess the question is, yeah, that's the question. How do I do that without messing it up? I guess it's more, the question comes more from a place of fear. Like, I don't want it to look. Because I want it to look real. I want it to look real. I mean, that's part of the, I mean, the only thing I want to look real is the skin. Everything else, I do flat for a reason. It's on purpose. I don't want it to look hyper realistic. I don't want it to look like a photograph, but I want you to know this is a person that could exist. You know, that's where I'm getting. To a degree, yes. True. Yeah. Okay. I see. Okay. Okay. I understand. Okay. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yes. I felt like, honestly, like I picked an easy one because this is a series, and from the series, this is the only one of the few that has so much movement and it's easy. Like, I was testing to see if I understood the concept of the different lines and the positioning of the lines and whatnot. So I picked an image on purpose that would make the process easier. So I would have to go through the process again with other images in which, you know, the body position and the way her face and her, like, instead of maybe having a profile, she's looking straight at you to see if I fully understand the concept. But with this, it was intentional. I wanted to make sure that I could digest the information better. So Thank you. Thank you. All right, Victor, will there be a recording of this call as well? Hello? Will there be a recording of this call as well? Okay, all right.
Yeah. Look. What happened?
I wanted to ask something, sorry. I have a question about the, I don't know how you call that in English, but I have the concept in Spanish and I can't remember right now what it is in English, but it's like, I can't remember now, I lost it. It's like the weight of the image, like, the values when you're, well, in this case, it's a sketch, so it's pencil, but I can see it's a sketch and it's pencil, but in my head, I can see it in color, and like I'm picturing the top of the composition being really like these really light hues of blues and whatnot, and then it gets heavier at the bottom. So is that what you would do? To make sure that the image is balanced, yeah, balance, eso era. So there's balance in the image, so it doesn't get like quote unquote heavy when you look at it. I don't know. Okay. I know it has nothing to do with what we're talking about right now, but I just wanted to ask about that. Okay. Yes, yes, exactly.
Not right now, no. Yes. Well, I think it's, I learned something. I learned a lot, and like I said before, it's like a good environment for me. A lot of knowledge here, and I just think that maybe, as we move forward, we'll probably be able to, as people will be able to like contribute as they see something happening, so that it maybe it's just not always on you doing all the talking.
I'm here. Everything or just in general? I really don't know what to say. I mean, you said it all. I mean, I really don't have much to say. Just good work. I don't really have anything to say.
Yes. no, it was cool. It was good to see Bill's work at first. You know what I liked is Bill said, you try to follow the original trace or your image, and then you get into the grid, and it almost like you have to just relax, And that's even I started doing it. I was like, it's almost like forcing your line, but a better word is let it guide you. And I learned a lot from just doing all six of them. And then yesterday I tried the horizontals, and it completely changed my image. So it was a great exercise. That was good to see you build it. You went ahead and attacked, or got into the grids. Jhana, wow. I mean, it's like we were saying last week, wait till you start getting it. It's going to be amazing. I mean, we all got our mistakes, but, that was Leonardo da Vinci's, you're going to fail. Learn from your mistakes, and we're all learning from mistakes. So this is good.
So wait, I have a question, Martin. Mm-hmm. How did Nietzsche get to be Martin?
That's my composer's name.
Oh, yeah, Nietzsche's your composer.
Martin's too plain. It's too mediocre. So I'll just flip it around.
Okay. Oh, okay.
Yeah, well, I see.
Now, I have a friend, his stage name is Clark Peters.
Uh-huh.
But his real name is Peter Clark. He did the same thing.
Yeah, no, it's I liked it. It was cool. It fit for me. I like it. Bill, have you tried putting your signature in the grid yet?
No, I haven't. But I'll explore that.
Yeah, I keep finding that route too for those portraits. It seems like so balanced and harmonious. I mean, I looked at you. That's the one. Victor. Meetup. Yeah, it goes through the order. Yeah, I did another version too, and I was just like that root too, just seeing, and even plugging in, pulling in the lines, it feels like it locks in a lot easier. Yeah. Lock it. Yeah, no, I did in that second round, I started like, oh, because you said connect the dots, but then I started realizing those other lines come into play if it's looking too stiff. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, well, in general, I'm excited. I'm really excited because I understand what's going on. I understand. I have a better understanding of what I'm doing. So that's lightning. And I don't know. I'm just happy that I'm getting to learn so much from, not only from my work and the feedback I'm getting from my own work, but the feedback every composer is getting on their own work, and it's refreshing to be in such a creative group. I haven't had this interaction in a while, so I'm really excited.
Say again, did you get the pack of herbs? Never mind, you missed it. Go ahead. I gotta get in there. But here's something that what I was trying to say with my visions, that, you know, today we have what, 2, 3, 4 people, right? But really what's happening is we're part of a tradition that's not visible. You know, we belong into this collective energy type pool of guys doing this work. And that's what's really important, that you remember that. It's important work that we do.
I'll go. Bill.
Well, who else? We got Mita. Oh, you just gonna plug them in there. Oh, you're up. Oh, yeah. No, I'm shiny. You want to put me in?
they have to be on. They have to be on the bench.
Okay. Sure, I'm glad to go in.
Yes. Well, you know, I need some guidance in that area. I mean, I was thinking about taking the last one I did and doing that in the other grids. Okay. Yes, right. Okay. Right, I got you.
As far as dominant diagonal? Yeah, let's see.
Hmm. Well, wouldn't it be the cheat vector because there's more information around that area than in the chin or the hat? Well, that's yeah, because for me that there's more meaty information there. If I focus on the chin, then the tension goes down there, and we miss the stuff above it. Right. Yep, I agree. Baroque. Well, okay, well, I look at the power. Femininity would be a Baroque. The sinister is, it has the dark side to it. A power that's sort of misapplied.
Bill, what's the story behind this? Didn't you say there was like she's a queen or something?
Yeah, that's a good question, Martin. The story is that she's one of the few female pharaohs, and under her rule, when her husband died, the son was alive. He was a baby. She took over, and she ruled even when he got old enough to take over. She banished him, but she was a real powerful character. She's the one who allegedly pioneered the obelisk that we have in our architecture today.
So, what it, Victor, didn't you say that the sinister can be kind of mysterious as well?
Yeah, right, okay. No. Mm-hmm. Right.
I also agree that I would like to see it on the Sinister as well. Like, I imagine that if this was played by an actor, I think of Grace Jones.
Yeah, right. Oh, perfect, yes. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Right. They're just suggestions. Right. Okay. Okay. Thanks.
Yeah. I gotta pick my which grid I'm gonna use and just work my grids. Not yet, but I was gonna use my computer for right now until I can do that.
For next week, I'm going to pick one out of the three that I did. I did another two sets. So I'll, yeah. Putting in work. I'm going to grab three so that way I have three out of all of them that look the best out of all the grids. And then go into the next layer, which is the curve, correct? Layer three, line. So that's my goal. So pick one, pick the three, pick one out of there, and then just focus on that one for a line strategy. So that way next week, it's like, okay, yeah, total three. Sounds good.
Okay, I would like to continue working on the same portrait that that I worked on today, but what I would like to do is do the first lesson on the same drawing, but design the composition intentionally. So, like what we covered about the different shadowing and whatnot, I would like to do that intentionally this time. And also would like to do two more on the same thing or the same composition. The same lesson, but on two different portraits. So it will be three different portraits. And just to make sure that I understand the first lesson completely. Okay.
Okay, so whenever you're ready, let me know.
Okay. All right, thank you.
Happy trails to you. Until,
ciao.
Huh? Uh-oh. What's that? Happy trails to you.
To whom? Whose birthday is it?
Oh, really? Okay.
Happy birthday.
Okay. Feliz Navidad.
Feliz Navidad.
No.
Cumpleaños feliz.
Feliz cumpleaños. Feliz cumpleaños, bonita.
Gracias.
Que se llenes muchas más, muchas más.
Gracias.
No hay de qué, bonita.
Well, I learned both at the same time, so Spanish and English are both, I learned both languages at the same time, but the official language here is Spanish, so I speak Spanish more than I do English. I speak it more often. We speak it every day. Yeah.
She's a Spanglish.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Yeah. Because of the amount of international companies that are based here and that have headquarters and offices here, the amount of bilinguals has increased over the last 10 years. So there's a lot more. There are a lot more English speakers than there used to be maybe 20 years ago. But in that case, it's more of a, because of a need, because of work and whatnot. But those who have, who learned English from childhood, like in my case, it's because we have family overseas, or our families originally come from the Caribbean or from somewhere else where English is the first language. Barbados and St. Lucia. Yeah. Really? Oh, cool. Okay.
For me,
that's cool. I got some. I was supposed to have another meeting at 8 o'clock, but if it's not too long, we can do it. Okay. It's another online. Okay.
Okay. All right, bye.